Hi, I'm JD Hillberry. In this video, I'm going to show you a lot of my artwork, and I'm not going to be explaining all the materials and techniques like I have in some of the other videos. In this one, I just want to give you an overall view of my work throughout the years and how it's changed, how I got started. I'm even going to show you some of my artwork that no one has even ever seen before, except for my family. This one will just give you an overall glimpse of what I do and how I got started. Hope you enjoy it. If you're not familiar with me, I'm the guy in this image you may have seen around the internet that so many people like to copy. It's a self-portrait pencil drawing that I've used for my logo for over 2 decades. Yes, I actually used to look like this. Okay, maybe I was flattering myself a little. Here are some other self-portraits I've done throughout the years so you can watch me grow older. By the way, everything you're going to see in this video is drawn on white paper, including all the backgrounds, the look of torn paper, and even the masking tape. Later on, I'm going to show you some work where I've even drawn the frame and the mat. If you haven't realized it yet, my thing is realistic drawing. So realistic that people actually think that some of the elements in my drawings are real three-dimensional objects instead of just drawn to look that way. Okay, so who am I? For over 23 years, I've been developing my techniques to take drawing to the extreme. Many people don't know this, but I'm actually a self-taught artist. I've never gone to art school, taken a single drawing lesson, or even a drawing workshop. I also only lasted 2 weeks in my high school art class. Now I'm letting you know this because I want you to realize that regardless of your drawing level now, you can learn to produce extremely realistic work like what I'm showing you in this video. Now when I say I'm self-taught, some people think that means that I've always been able to draw like this, and that's not the case at all. When I started drawing, my work looked a lot like other people's out there. It lacked the punch and the range of values that could make it stand out from the rest. When I began, I exhibited my artwork in local art shows and had very little interest, let alone sales. And I didn't realize it at the time, but when you exhibit your work, you're actually competing with other artists in other mediums. I'm not talking about competing for prize money or first place ribbons. I'm talking about competing for the attention of the art patrons, the people who might want to buy your artwork. I realized that my work was competing with colorful paintings, high contrast photography, and other two-dimensional work that would grab people's attention and draw them in. My drawings also lacked a range of textures to keep it interesting for viewers. Back then, my drawings were very detailed, but from 5 or 10 feet away, nobody could see the detail, so they weren't interested in coming closer for a better look. When I tried to get more contrast with graphite alone, it resulted in a very distracting shine in the darkest areas. If you're familiar with my work, you know that's one of my pet peeves. Okay, now I'm going to take a break from this slideshow of my current work to show you what I'm talking about. Here's a portrait that I did in 1989. Now you may be saying, this is a really good drawing and I'd be thrilled if I could do that. In my opinion, it's not a bad drawing, but it definitely lacks the visual pop that would grab people's attention to be on par with all the other art out there. It was right around this time that I came to the conclusion that if I was going to make a living at this, I needed to be able to increase the range of values to make my work stand out more. Let's compare it with another portrait that I did later on, after I'd learned to expand the range of values and textures. Okay, just so you think your eyes aren't drawn to this baby image because it's bigger and it's cute, here's another comparison with the heads the same size, along with an older guy. Okay, now that you know how my artistic journey began and how it started to change throughout the years, I want to tell you a little bit about where I am now in my art career. Now, I'm not going to say this to try to brag about my accomplishments. I just want you to realize that this has been my full-time job for over 2 decades. I've been selling my drawings and teaching my art techniques. I'm not some professional internet marketer that's trying to make a fast buck by selling how to draw videos. There's enough of those already out on the internet. My artwork has been successful because I've been able to make it stand out from the crowd. And my techniques are successful because I teach other people how to make their drawings do the same. Now, as I said, I'm a totally self-taught artist. These days, I tell people that even though I didn't go to art school, my drawing technique book did. Drawing Realistic Textures in Pencil has sold over 65,000 copies and can be found in art schools and libraries all over the world. It's even been translated into 2 languages. My artwork has won over 50 awards in nationally acclaimed fine art exhibits. It has been featured on billboards, magazines, newspapers, and television interviews. Back when I was doing the gallery thing, my drawings could be purchased in galleries and frame shops in over 35 states. My books and workshops are successful because I teach valuable techniques that allow even beginners to see extraordinary results in a short amount of time. Make sure you click the link below so you can go to my website to see some of my students' work and their comments about attending the classes. Okay, let's get back to your regularly scheduled program of showing more recent work while I ramble on a little bit more. Now, not all my work is this bizarre illusion stuff. I've been lucky enough to sell my work regardless of the subject matter, and my techniques work regardless of what you may choose to draw. Here are some of what I call my hand series. I love the contrast of textures I was able to achieve between the young and the old hands. To me, these drawings are like doing portraits without showing the face. You can kind of tell who the people are and what their relationship is just by looking at their hands. I got interested in doing this series when my kids were growing up. Speaking of kids, here's another interesting thought I had recently while talking to my 18-year-old son about music. To me, visual art has a lot in common with music. Good music, in my opinion, has dynamics. Some of the, quote, music he listens to is lacking in dynamics. There aren't any subtle nuances to get my attention. To me, music like that is like artwork with no subtle details and textures to explore. By the same token, I don't like elevator music that's so bland and in the background that you don't even notice it unless you make a point of listening. To me, that portrait I did back in '89 is elevator music. And you can't get people's attention with elevator music. Okay, let's get back to showing you more current stuff. I'm going to start the slideshow again, and what you'll be seeing probably won't have anything to do with what I'm talking about. Here's another correlation between music and art. Learning how to draw is just like learning how to play a musical instrument. If you spend all your time practicing it wrong, you're not going to get much better. You can learn much faster by having someone show you how to do it right. It saves time and disappointment, and it keeps you from getting stuck at that average level. And unless artists take the steps to improve their work, it will stay that way forever. Can you imagine what it would feel like if your drawing ability didn't improve for the entire rest of your life? How would it feel to know that you could have excelled in something you love, but you decided not to? Sooner or later, most people simply get tired of having the same problems over and over again with their drawings, and they simply quit drawing. I think it's pretty depressing to think about quitting something you love. I think life is too short to live like that. Ooh, sorry, this is getting a little heavy here, talking about the end of your life. Here's a picture to help lighten the mood a little. In this one, I was having a little fun with my nose in one of the signs where they used my self-portrait. So, with my upcoming video series I'll be offering, you'll be able to learn my techniques at home instead of attending a workshop. Some of these videos will be free, and others will be full-length, in-depth tutorials that you'll be able to purchase and download from my secure server. Now, of course, nothing can compare to attending a live drawing workshop, so I can actually see you performing the techniques and then give you all the individual attention you need. But these videos are the closest thing to attending one of the classes. So I know if you're still watching this video, you're probably interested in learning how to improve your drawing. So I hope you'll join me so you can learn the techniques that I use that can transform your drawings into high contrast, eye-catching works of art that have a definite wow factor. If you have your desire to take your work to the next level, make sure you sign up on my email list to be notified of my workshops, videos, and tutorials. And please put your questions and comments down below the video here. I actually read these and respond to them. And if you want to make sure you don't miss any of the free tutorials, you'll want to subscribe to my channel. Whoa, that one made me dizzy. I gotta go lay down. Thanks for watching.